You're at 476 to 498 CAS at Mount Clemens, Michigan.
Successful missions and imprisoned for 8 months. After the war, he spent 30 years as a Detroit teacher, as well as an assistant principal. Jefferson will lie in state at the Charles H. Wright Museum between 3 p.m. and 8 p.m. His funeral is on Saturday.
A Republican candidate for governor of Michigan pleaded not guilty to several misdemeanor charges related to the January 6th U.S. Capitol riots. Ryan Kelly appeared via video for a brief hearing in federal court in Washington, D.C., weeks after he was arrested as five FBI agents raided his home in Allendale, west of Grand Rapids. Authorities allege that Kelly was caught on video during last year's riot.
High gas prices are concerning for many people, but there are ways people can help ease the pain in their wallet. WWJ's Ryan Marshall joins us live with more details. Good afternoon, Ryan.
Well, good afternoon, Tony. Pumping gas is painful for many Michiganders, despite average gas prices for a gallon of unleaded falling below $5 per gallon nationally and here at home. Patrick DeHaan is the head of analysis at Gas Buddy. He says, do your homework when it comes to filling up at the pump.
I always encourage motorists to be aware of what prices are around you. Using an app like Gas Buddy or Google or Waze can show you what gas prices are in your neck of the woods. So, you know, there's always a potential to find a lower price. Many stations are charging different prices. And if you're aware of where those lower prices are, you can save 10, 20, even 30 cents a gallon on a fill-up.
He also says that some gas stations have loyalty programs that you can join that may save you money each time you pump. Ryan Marshall, WWJ News Radio 950.
The federal government now reportedly talking about leaving it up to the states to set auto emission standards. So how will that fly with automakers? We get more now live from WWJ Autobeat reporter Jeff Gilbert. Jeff.
If it's an interesting proposal, that's all it is at this point, Jackie, a proposal coming out of the Transportation Department, it would have each state set its own targets and report to the government on how it's meeting those targets. They would still have to be in line with the goals set by the federal government. Guidehouse Insights analyst Sam Abul-Samad says this could be a recipe, for confusion when it comes to the auto industry.
Auto industry for many years, and regulators for that matter, have argued that it's best to have one national standard for emissions and fuel economy.
Now, the government already has rules requiring car makers to cut greenhouse gases about 5 to 10% a year through 2026. Reporting live, I'm Jeff Gilbert, WWJ, Radio 950.
WWJ News Time, it's 2:08. That means it's time for traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th. Let's start with a look at traffic. Here's Tracy McCaskey.
And this report is sponsored by Oaks Roofing. Checking the AAA GMKMC, our crash is cleared. Westbound I-54 on that ramp to north and southbound I-75. Stone vehicle out of the way. Southbound I-75 into traffic from Holbrook is cleared. Malfunctioning traffic lights remain a factor. We have power out. Traffic very heavy in this area. We received calls from tipsters, including Sylvia. Dearborn Heights area, Telegraph Road, and Annapolis. There's a road work in the area with delays in...
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, Ms. Janine, how are you?
I'm fine.
You'll be ready in a half an hour? I'll see you then, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
Exit ramp to eastbound M59 is closed until 6. Oaks Roofing is rated A+ with the Better Business Bureau, and this month they are offering a 50-year GAF factory non-prorated warranty that covers both labor and materials for free. Go to oaksroofing.com. That's O-A-K-E-S roofing.com. I'll have your next traffic update 218 from the Mann's Lumber and Mill Work Traffic Center.
Well, this afternoon we'll have sunshine and some clouds, a high around 84 degrees. We'll get down to 67 for a low tonight under a partly cloudy sky. Turning out mostly cloudy for tomorrow with an afternoon shower or two, a high close to 80. Some beautiful weather Saturday and Sunday with sunshine and patchy clouds, with low humidity, high temperature both days, again near 80. By Monday, it will be a little bit warmer with intervals of clouds and sun. The breeze will pick up, and there could be a stray shower or thunderstorm by the afternoon. High Monday around 88 degrees. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Brian Thompson on WWJ News Radio 950.
Currently in Ann Arbor, we have mostly cloudy skies. It's 80 degrees, and Pontiac also mostly cloudy and 78 degrees. At Mount Clemens, it's cloudy and 78. And at Detroit Metro Airport, we have mostly sunny skies and 79 degrees.
WWJ News 9210. Many schools in the Big Ten allow alcohol sales in their college stadiums, but not Michigan. Some state legislators have introduced bills to change that. State Representative Graham Fuller has co-sponsored a bill in the House to lift the
college from those universities. So I think it will make Michigan universities that have football, hockey, basketball to have a little more of a competitive edge.
Filler says it's also a safety issue, as many people tailgate before a game, causing binge drinking. A similar bill has also been introduced in the state Senate.
The rebuild of the Detroit Red Wings roster continuing tonight as they have the number 8 pick in the opening round of the NHL draft in Montreal. With the draft this week and free agency beginning in the NHL next week, there could be quite a bit of turnover on the Wings roster this offseason. Speaking to reporters recently, General Manager Steve Yzerman was asked if he's made any decisions yet on which of the Red Wings free agents he'll bring back for next season and which ones he'll let walk.
I haven't ruled out bringing anyone back off the top of my head. I can't think of that. I've said that specifically to anyone. I do have interest in bringing in all of our players, but that'll be determined. It'll find a decision one way or the other shortly before or shortly after July 13th.
July 13th is the official start of free agency in the NHL. The draft begins this evening at 7 o'clock.
Coming up in 2 minutes, a rise in the number of Michigan workers losing jobs and filing for unemployment benefits in the past week. Economists think this could become a trend. I'm Murray Feld, WWJ News Time 212.
A bad team facing a good team is never completely out of it.
Nick Costos, co-host of You Better You Bet. 3 to 7 p.m. Eastern on the BetQL Network.
There's 162 games in the season. The best teams are going to lose 60-plus times, and the worst teams are going to win 60-plus times. Each night is its own individual entity. That's what makes betting on the baseball regular season so much fun.
All the insight you need to bet smarter is at BetQL.com. And listen to You Better You Bet with Nick Costos and Ken Barkley, streaming weekdays from 3 to 7 p.m. Eastern on Odyssey.
Here at the Almond Joy Factory, where tropical vibes abound, we use soft, fresh, tasty coconut.
The crunchiest almonds and delicious chocolate candy.
Ah, but do you know what our most important ingredient is? Sometimes you feel like a nut.
Sometimes you don't.
Almond Joy's got
nuts
and something even way better than that. Yes, Almond Joy is made with almonds.
Michigan. I'm a private real estate investor who buys several houses a month, and I want to buy more. No matter what your situation is, I can help. I buy vacant houses, completely trashed houses, inherited houses, houses that are behind on payments, any type of house. Bring it on. If you own a house and want to sell it fast, call me, Mike, at Mike Buys Houses, 248-900-1010. And be sure to check us out online at selltomike.com. That's selltomike.com.
Is brought to you by Mega Millions. You're 6 numbers away from your moment.
Friday's Mega Millions jackpot is $400 million.
Hurry in to Mattress Firm's July 4th sale. Get a king bed for the price of a queen or a queen for twins and save up to $500 on Sealy. Plus, get a free adjustable base with qualifying Sealy purchase up to a $499 value. Or shop Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America, and save $500 on all Tempur-Breeze mattresses, and get a $300 instant gift good towards sleep accessories. Only at Mattress Firm. Restrictions apply. See store or mattressfirm.com for details.
Look through your children's eyes to see the true magic of a boy. It's a storybook world for them. You look and see a tree. They see the wrinkled face of a wizard with arms outstretched to the sky. Treasure and pebbles. They see a windy path that could lead to adventure. And they see you, their fearless guide to this fascinating world.
Find the four.
jump of nearly 4,800 from the week before, but it's also more than twice the number of weekly layoffs we used to see before the pandemic. Some of these layoffs are related to auto production being cut, some of that due to supply chain issues, but other cuts are coming as companies adjust the workforce, preparing for an economic slowdown. We've seen that happen with Stellantis. In fact, the auto industry has been leading the nation in job cuts over the past month. Technology companies have been cutting workers, and so have mortgage companies, as higher interest rates slow down home buying and refinancing. Murray Feldman, WWJ, News Radio 950.
You'll be seeing millions in improvements at Detroit Metro Airport in the very near future.
U.S. Senators Debbie Stabenow and Gary Peters have announced that the FAA is awarding Metro Airport more than $49 million in federal funding for terminal improvements. $28 million will be used to rehabilitate public restrooms, $17 million to repair baggage claim belts, and $4 million to provide a replacement program for the passenger boarding bridges. Stabenow says having reliable and safe air service is crucial for tourism, commerce, and economic development. The money was made possible by the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act. Beth Fisher, WWJ News Radio 950.
Something new coming to Detroit, and it'll be the first of its kind in the nation. The U.S. Department of Agriculture will open an office in the city, which will be the first dedicated to urban farms. Urban farmers struggle with zoning laws and livestock restrictions that make it difficult for farmers without a lot of money. Officials recently held a listening session with urban farmers in Eastern Market, but a spot for the office has not yet been announced.
WWJ News Time 218. That means it's time for traffic and weather together on the 8th. Once again, with a look at traffic, here's Tracy McCaskill.
And checking the AAA traffic, monitoring a number of slowdowns. This report sponsored by Oakland County Veterans Services. So starting here, malfunctioning traffic lights due to power outages are a big factor in Farmington Hills, parts of 12 and 13 mile between Drake and Farmington Road. Again, treat the area as a four-way stop. Also in Dearborn Heights, the lights affected Telegraph and Annapolis Road. There's also road work in this area, so slight delay. Time now for the NECA IBEW Local 58 construction alert. Westbound 696 ramp to north and southbound I-75 is closed through the fall here. The best way around this, and you're going to need one, is southbound Van Dyke onto westbound 8 Mile, and then from there, get back to I-75. Now keep in mind, the traffic lights are still reportedly out here too at 8 Mile and the Van Dyke intersection there. Northbound I-75 from 8 Mile to 696, the right lane closure through Monday. Westbound 696 from Drake to Novi Road. You have delays entering that work zone. Another slow story, southbound 275 after 6 Mile. Two lanes open, and the 275 southbound ramp to southbound in 14 is closed until 3. And a reminder here, MDOT says the 2nd Avenue Bridge replacement over I-94 in Detroit is scheduled for late July. Exact dates have not been announced, but it will include a one-week complete closure of I-94 between I-75 and M-10. So get ready for that. Join Oakland County, a local veterans resource fair, to learn